brown bear population of the Cantabrian Mountains is one of the smallest, most isolated, and most endangered European brown bear populations. Most of the distribution range of Cantabrian bears overlaps with high human and crop densities, cattle farming, and dense road networks, which have reduced the extension of areas crucial for bear food and shelter. Nevertheless, during the last decade, this bear population has shown a natural increase. Unfortunately, we completely lack direct information on the process of subadult dispersal and the actual connection between the eastern and western subpopulations, as well as subadult mortality, which could affect the natural dynamic of the whole population. Indeed, it has recently been hypothesized that mortality due to anthropogenic causes might still be occurring in the eastern sector of the region. This information is thus essential to understand the future viability of these bears. The most urgent priority for the conservation of the Cantabrian brown bear is the study of juvenile dispersal, and the most appropriate method to obtain this information is the capture and radiocollaring of subadults. In fact, telemetry will allow for understanding of the key habitats during the different phases of bear biology, the physical barriers that bears are faced with and how to remove them, and the dangers potentially affecting the survival of dispersing individuals. For years, Spain has been one of the only countries within worldwide brown bear distribution where a telemetry project has never been carried out. But in the last few months, after more than 5 years of continuous meetings with the different administrations of the Cantabrian Mountains, our research team, the Cantabrian Brown Bear Research Group, based in the UMIB Research Unit of Biodiversity, has finally received authorization to capture and radiocollar bears in the Cantabrian Mountains. Before this recent approval, local administrations had rejected all proposals to capture and mark bears for more than 20 years. Under this new political scenario, unique for the Cantabrian Mountains, it is imperative to start bear capture and radiocollaring now. This IBA grant thus represents a critical opportunity to start a long-term project on brown bear telemetry in the Cantabrian Mountains. With this telemetry project, my research group and I expect to acquire direct information on the roots and movement patterns of dispersing subadults, to understand the activity rhythms of dispersers in relation to habitat and the different periods of a bare year. That is, at the beginning of the spring, after den exit, when adults start mating, during hyperphagia, and during the winter. Few individuals seem to hibernate here. We hope to define landscape permeability to bear movements and major corridors allowing bears to move between the two subpopulations, to understand the mechanisms allowing bears to share the landscape with people in human-modified environments through the study of movement patterns and rhythms of activity, and to acquire information on the causes and rates of subadult mortality in the Cantabrian range. We will use a minimally invasive capture system, which is more efficient and selective, as well as safer and more compassionate than traditional methods used to trap bears. Among others, the scientific team of the project comprises Professor John Swenson, Dr. Andrés, and Dr. Nuria Fandos. The IBA grant will allow us to start the telemetry project as soon as possible by purchasing our first GPS units for bears and completing the preparation of the remote system of bear capture. Because of the vulnerability of this small, isolated, and still endangered brown bear population, the information that we get from this telemetry study will be vital for the long-term conservation of this species in the Cantabrian Mountains. Immediately after the IBA funding, the COVID-19 slightly delayed the project, but we are currently working in collaboration with local administrations to start first captures this winter, or at the latest, next spring.